Hello, in this video I'm going to show how to use the KBV Fire profiles to validate your bundles and how to use the Eerie Health solution for that. So first there is this update.kbv.de server, and there's a folder here you can find these profiles for validation. And at the moment we have integrated version 1.0.1. We are in the process of integration version 1.0.2, but at the moment we are still using the old version. So if you go into our source code, you will see that here we have a folder called KBV Fire ERP version 1. And basically this folder just contains an uncompressed version of this file here. So this is the file, and then internally we are loading this file into the HAPI Fire validator, and now I'm going to show to start this and how to use this. So I'm just going to start eerie.health in the normal dev version. So this just started the system, and we have a script. It's called validate bundle. And this script, it's written in JavaScript, so it's using JUnit test, using the Nashorn engine in JDK 11 to run this test. And basically what it's doing a post to the URL http://localhost:8080validate. Also, what you can do is our system always comes with the most recent Open API definitions. So I think if you go here, and then if you type in openapi.yaml, I think so. No, then let's check .json. Okay, so currently I don't find them, but they are automatically generated. So we come with this data. I would just stretch it. Quarkus open API UL. So here, this is what we are using. Let's see what's the right UL. Okay, so it's /q/openapi. So here it is. So this is the Open API configuration, and our system is always shipped, and this is always automatically generated. And the endpoint that's important for you, it's the validate endpoint. And the validate endpoint, it reads JSON. And this is exactly what this particular test case here is doing. So it's reading this JSON file. So this is the JSON file that it's reading. And then it's posting this JSON file to the validate endpoint. And there is this JavaScript test file. And we can just run the test validate bundle. And what this will do is it will read the JSON from the disk and then send it to the server. And the first time, it takes a little bit longer because our system, it's loading all the profiles. And this takes so long because snapshots are generated. We currently don't have a plan yet how to enhance the performance. But the good news is this is only for the first time. So you can currently see that the first time that this took around, let's check how long it took. So the first time it took 8.3 seconds, and if we run it a second time, it should run a lot faster. So I would guess like 2 seconds. Or actually it only takes 765 milliseconds. And now I will also show you what happens if I change something here. So now let's make this invalid. So let's just remove something which is necessary. So here from the, let's just remove the birth date from the patient. Is the patient? I think so. So let's save and then let's run this again. Yeah, so now you get an error here. And basically what it says is, it says that the patient is missing a birth date. So let me just find this here. Birth date. So let's control F. Control F. Birth. Yeah, here. So the patient birth date, it's at least one has to be there, but only zero are found. And all the other errors are part of this error. Because if something is missing, The validator can't assign this particular object to a certain or this particular resource to a certain profile, and therefore there are lots of other errors saying that a certain assignment was not to the correct profile. So for example here it says that in the subject the assigned patient does not match the profile. And actually we don't really care about these errors, we only care about this error. Because if we fix this error, all the other errors will disappear as well. So I will show you this. So let's just undo what I just did. Save again. Run it again. And now if we remove the search, we will see that it's valid again. And thanks a lot. And I hope that you enjoy the validator.